Macomb County, 27 cities, townships, and villages. But what we're building is momentum.
People talk about the building, but what is that?
Creating a different tomorrow with the steps we take today. Always remembering the opportunity that comes with changing the world.
Welcome to the stage, WXYZ Channel 7 Weekend Anchor and native of Macomb County, Jennifer Ann Wilson.
Good evening, everyone. I am, as you heard, Jennifer Ann Wilson, a reporter and anchor with WXYZ, and I am 6'2", and yes, I do play soccer. I know you were wondering, so I thought I'd clear that up. I had the incredible privilege of growing up right here in Macomb County. And in fact, I spent a whole lot of time in this very room growing up. My parents used to bring me to the theater, and I'd sit out in the auditorium where you're sitting right now, looking up at the stage. And I was a bit of an obnoxious kid, and every time there was a child actor that stepped up on stage, I'd grab my mom or my dad, I'd say, hey, like really loud, how did that kid get up there? Who let them up there? And I would yell it pretty loud. I did that a couple of times and they stopped taking me. But the privilege of growing up here in Macomb County, I was actually able to get up here at a pretty young age through an incredible group called the Macomb Junior Players. I had the opportunity to perform on this stage all throughout middle school, high school, performing to full audiences. This group, it's now called All the World's a Stage, and they're still doing incredible things for the youth here. So that is one of the many privileges I had growing up right here in Macomb County. I went to school here. I attended Fox and Mohawk Elementary, Iroquois Middle School. Any alumni? Yeah, that's all right, be proud. I know we never give our elementary and middle schools any credit, do we? But they're very important. I went to Chippewa Valley High School, and there we go. Got some big reds in the house. And I'm pretty sure that at some point in every single one of my classrooms, I was told, probably multiple times, that I talked too much. Got in a little trouble for that. So to all my teachers, look at me now. Thank you. put that skill to good use. So for any of you who might be sitting out there thinking like, hey, how did I get up here? I have the incredible honor and privilege of introducing you to the man responsible. He's a man that my younger brothers and sisters know as their DARE officer. My aunt still thinks of as the sheriff. And my dad had the privilege of calling his friend. And now I too can call him my friend. Put your hands together for the man who will deliver your State of the County address, your very own county executive, Mark Hackel!
Thank you, darling. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Wow. Welcome to Macomb County. And thank you for joining us for the annual State of the County Address. For those that are first-timers, I'm just going to kind of forewarn you here. This is kind of less of a speech and kind of a more of a dinner show, as you can already tell. For those of you that have been here before, you realize that you've got to watch the show before you get to have dinner. So it's that 45-minute opportunity. But once again, I want to thank Jennifer for that kind introduction and for helping us celebrate this evening. Thank you. And before we get on with the show, I want to take a quick moment to recognize and welcome some of the few individuals. Starting with our county, or I guess if you will, I'll start with the regional partners that I have here today. And I'm very fortunate that they actually took the time to show up here. First and foremost, I'd like to recognize Wayne County Executive, Mr. Warren Evans. Warren. We also have in the house the Oakland County Executive, Mr. L. Brooks Patterson. Brooks is wise to this. He's a sly fox. He understands it's about a 45-minute production, and so he waits for the introduction of himself, takes a quick nap, and then joins us for the festivities afterwards. Warren and I are on to you, Brooks. We know why you're sitting back there. So. Also with us, my friend to the north, if you will, Chairman of the St. Clair County Board of Commissioners, Mr. Jeff Bohm. Jeff. And although he couldn't be here this evening, representing Mayor Mike Duggan from the City of Detroit, Chief Operating Officer, Mr. David Masseron. David. I would like to recognize our countywide elected officials who are some in attendance here tonight. The Public Works Commissioner, Candace Miller, Treasurer, Larry Rocca, Clerk, Fred Miller, Prosecutor, Eric Smith, and Sheriff, Tony Wickersham. If you're here, please stand. We also have with us members of the Macomb County Board of Commissioners, the judges from our circuit and district court, as well as the probate court, led by their chief judge, James Biernett. Judges, thank you for being here. My brother's the only one that wanted to stand up. So, and believe me, he's only here for the festivities afterwards, too. So, we also have with us, and I love recognizing this, because how many times can you say you have a Supreme Court Justice from Macomb County? Ladies and gentlemen, David Viviano. Yeah. I want to thank all of you for your service. I want to extend a special thank you to our presenting sponsor as well, Ascension Macomb Oakland, along with the other sponsors who are in your program. Also to the Macomb and Sterling Heights Chambers who helped us put this program together. Melanie, I want to thank you. And Grace, I not only want to thank you, but I also would like to congratulate you on your 40 years of service to the Chamber. As many of you may or may not know, Grace is going to be leaving her position at the Chamber and as the Executive Director, but she's still going to be sticking around for some of the special projects. So with that being said, Grace, I just want to thank you for your leadership and all that you've done for the Macomb County Chamber as well as Macomb County. Thank you, Grace. Where are you at? She's so shy. As you know, this year we celebrated Macomb County's bicentennial, 200 years. And that 200 years of history was put on display through a number of community events. We showcased our rich heritage with cultural displays, panel discussions, and some special events. We even attended a few parades and lit off some fireworks, and of course, we had some birthday cake. But I gotta tell you, to me, the high point of this celebration was our torch relay. This 200-mile nonstop relay was all about connecting our communities and showcasing the continuous progress of this place we call home. There were 200 torchbearers that ran an unbroken 40-hour relay, which passed through all 27 of our communities here. I had the opportunity to be there the entire time and witness the enthusiasm and the excitement. And folks, it looked a little bit like this. pretty amazing. People from all walks of life had an opportunity to be a part of this historic event. And even the guy in the red, I don't know if you caught that visual of the guy with the red, that was my brother Bill, okay? He even ran a mile in this particular thing. The reason I put him in there is because I am stuck with that visual going to bed every night. I wanted the rest of you to have that very same sleepless opportunity as well. But I'm gonna tell you, I think really what was most interesting about this is carrying this torch is what really added to the excitement. And in fact, it stole the show. It was amazing how many people wanted to take a picture with that torch. And you know where we got it? It was created by Macomb County College students and staff. The torch itself stands 28 inches tall, 7.5 inches wide, and weighs less than 2.5 pounds. They incorporated in the design of this several special symbols representing the county's history and heritage. For example, the apple, linking us to our agricultural roots. The wheel represents our automotive heritage. And the symbol of the manufacturing was the gear in the middle. The peregrine falcon feathers on the side reminds us to keep reaching higher every day. This community-inspired torch tells a story about our past, but I think in the design they also looked at it as helping to light our way into the future. And I want to thank President Jim Sawyer and the folks at the college who transformed our vision for this torch into an incredible reality. Jim, thank you very much. It has been a privilege to serve as county executive during this historic year, and I want to take a moment, if I may, and thank the voters here in Macomb County for allowing me an opportunity to serve as your county executive for the next 4 years. As a kid born and raised here, I am so proud of this county, and I promise that I'll continue to work every day to serve your interests, and more importantly, to maintain each and every one of your trusts. Oh, leave me hanging, man. And with that, I do have to make two more mentions. People that probably, I keep talking about my brother Bill, we go back and forth, but there are two other people that are very special in my life that have really been there to help me through all of the challenges that you face as a public official. And one of those, I think many of you recognize and know, my father, Bill Hackel. Dad, where you at? And she's probably gonna kill me for it, but my beautiful wife, Tracy. Tracy? Now, on with the show. A lot has been accomplished over these past 8 years, and the driving force has been our county charter. And it has allowed us an opportunity to bring about a fundamental change in government. This new form of government has, without question, increased our influence. Through the charter, the county now has a consistent elected voice to speak on behalf of 870,000 residents, allowing us to have greater impact on everything from local priorities to federal programs. Simply put, because of the charter, county government has become more accessible, more accountable, and far more influential. So, how do we know it's working? Well, we continue to use 6 key metrics to track our progress. The first metric is our growing population and diversity. Last year, nearly 4,000 new residents made Macomb their home. And since 2010, we have been adding, on average, 12 new residents per day. Our minority population keeps growing. In fact, 11% of Macomb County residents were born outside of the United States. Clearly, Macomb County continues to be a place where people want to live. The second metric is the county's rising educational attainment. Since 2010, Macomb County's education profile has added more than 35,000 associate, bachelor, and graduate degrees. And this trend is likely to continue, especially through creative partnerships, like the recent tuition discount programs offered to county employees by Central Michigan and Davenport Universities, and we thank them, and the new transfer partnership, like the ones with Oakland University and Walsh College, where community college students can now transfer 80 or more credit hours towards their bachelor's degrees. The third metric is family income. In 2017, Macomb's annual median household income increased to more than $60,000. A few years ago, our family income slipped below the state average. Today, our household income is 9% higher than the state average. And as you probably know, this restores the spending power and produces significant benefits to our local economy. The fourth metric we use is jobs. Jobs are on the rise in Macomb. Our unemployment rate is down to 4%, and our workforce grew to more than 445,000 individuals, which is just shy of an all-time high. And the fifth metric, housing. In 2018, we added 1,500 new housing units here in Macomb County, and the median home value increased by more than $8,000. Our last metric, financial stability. Let me simplify this for you. For 8 consecutive years, the county has adopted a balanced budget and continues to maintain its enviable AA+ bond rating. This is due to the efforts of the countywide elected officials, the department heads, the employees, the board of commissioners' involvement and engagement during the budgetary process, and I gotta tell you, a lot of credit goes out to the director of our finance department and the folks in that office who do an incredible job. Steve Smigel and his staff help us maintain that fiscal stability. That was probably Steve leading the applause. So, and if you think about it, when it comes to fiscal stability, you know, that's what you expect from government. But in Macomb County, all those folks I just got through talking about, we understand it. And that is the way we operate. So clearly, all these positive metrics provide convincing reasons why people want to make Macomb their home. In fact, that phrase, make Macomb your home, has been able to capture the true spirit of what we are building here, a thriving place that people are proud to call home. This community-inspired brand has provided us with a powerful platform to champion our county. We're using interactive content to showcase everything from special events to homegrown businesses, seasonal campaigns, and spirited competitions to provide residents and visitors with an opportunity for destination experiences, putting a spotlight on shopping, dining, arts, culture, and recreation. But Make Macomb Your Home is more than a tagline. It's become a digital trend. There are now more than 30,000 people who are sharing content on social media. Each month, our posts are seen by more than 338,000 individuals. And this past year, 4 million people explored Macomb County by using Make Macomb Your Home. These four simple words have created an economic advantage and an emotional connection to this place we call home. We're also building and better connecting the community with One Macomb. One Macomb is our countywide initiative created to embrace, share, and celebrate our increasing diversity. Our vision is to appreciate the many cultures and create a community that is welcoming everyone. We have done this by hosting naturalization ceremonies, coordinating with service agencies, and engaging ethnic organizations. The networking is having a positive impact on Macomb County. As I stated earlier, there were 4,000 new people who made Macomb their home this past year. What percentage of those new residents do you think were international? The answer might surprise you. 72% of all new Macomb County residents this past year were foreign-born. Think about that. The majority of our new neighbors no longer come from another county, but rather they now come from another country. And we know this. People choose to live where they feel welcome. And this population trend is a testament to the fact that people feel welcome in Macomb. In addition to creating a more welcoming Macomb community, we are building a better Macomb in several ways. First, we are building a healthier Macomb by improving public health, mental health, and physical health. With regards to public health, our health department was quick to react to a statewide hepatitis A outbreak. They set up 360 outreach clinics, which administered vaccines to nearly 12,000 at-risk members. The health department was equally quick to respond when PFAS chemicals were discovered near Selfridge Air Base and was a pioneer in the use of video technology for case management in communicable diseases. The next area, mental health. Although there have been some improvements, In this case, the challenges appear to be outpacing our ability to respond. One of the biggest setbacks has been a substantial cut in mental health funding from the state. Our community mental health agency has seen a $38 million cut in Medicaid funding over the past 2.5 years. We know there are a lot of unmet needs in the state, but we will continue to push for improved mental health funding when the new legislature and governor take office next year. On the physical health side, the county is seeing improvements through several major investments by our local hospital systems. McLaren Macomb has launched the first phase of its planned $68 million expansion of their emergency department and trauma center. When completed, it will have doubled in size and will become the county's largest emergency medical center. Ascension Macomb Oakland. And I like the fact that Macomb comes before Oakland, by the way, for those that care. Brooks is sleeping, he didn't hear it anyways. So, Ascension Macomb Oakland, our presenting sponsor, they're in the midst of a $48 million expansion of their East Tower on its Warren campus, expanding from 4 floors to 7 floors and creating 220 private rooms. Henry Ford Macomb just cut the ribbon on a $40 million expansion of its surgical center, which utilizes the most advanced technology and includes a state-of-the-art hybrid surgical facility. And speaking of Henry Ford, we were excited to hear that the president and CEO, Barbara Rossman, had just been given an additional role with the parent company. She was named the chief nursing officer for the entire Henry Ford Health System. Barbara, congratulations. There were two other health-related announcements this past year, both impacting our veterans. First, the former 103-acre Seville Manor Army Garrison in Chesterfield Township was purchased by the state and will become the site for the new 128-bed long-term care facility for veterans. This campus... This campus was designed around national best practices and will be the prototype for 7 new veterans facilities to be built in the state over the next 10 years. There was intense competition for the Southeast Michigan site, and we were proud to have been able to bring that here to Macomb County. We are equally proud that the nationally prominent Eisenhower Center has selected Macomb County and Selfridge Air Base as the site for its newest residential treatment center for veterans suffering from traumatic brain injuries. The center will offer a comprehensive array of rehabilitative services that will guide veterans and their families back to healthy and productive lives. Interesting, we have a history of the defense industry here in Macomb County, where we have a sense of pride in making things that protect those who protect us. But now here in Macomb County, facilities are being built to serve those who have served us. And speaking of those who have served us, we have a special guest with us this evening. This individual served with her spouse, in the U.S. Army during World War II and is a resident of Macomb County. This past Thanksgiving, she celebrated her 100th birthday. Ladies and gentlemen, help me welcome, if you will, Miss Nina Daly. Nina? Where's Nina Hayden? There's Nina, right there. Nina, thank you for your service. Amazing. And thank you for making Macomb your home. So that actually woke Brooks up. He started waving. He thought everybody was cheering for him or something again. No, that was Nina's moment, Brooks. So in addition to building a healthier Macomb, we're also building a safer Macomb. The Sheriff's Office partnered with our planning department and created a web-based crime mapping system. This allows for better deployment of law enforcement officers and more complete information to the public. The Sheriff's Office is also utilizing drone technology to enhance tactical investigative techniques. And as well, they're using 3D technology to better document crash and crime scenes. And at ComTech, We are leveraging its advanced technology to, if you will, make our schools safer. By using video and telecommunications links, we can now connect directly into a school's security camera system. We all hope that the day never comes, but if it does, this unique partnership will provide a tactical advantage to our first responders to keep kids safe here in Macomb County. Macomb is also becoming more caring, especially for our most vulnerable population. Here are just some of the examples. Our Office of Senior Services connected with hundreds of volunteers and organizations looking to give back. The Community Actions Agency hosted resource fairs, services that were provided to 307 families. And an innovative partnership between Senior Service and Martha Teaberry has created a more extensive adult daycare program known as Goldenberry. And our outstanding Macomb Food Program, they distributed nearly 3 million pounds of food through partnerships with more than 60 organizations. You know, it's interesting. Oftentimes, the fine work of these community service staff goes unnoticed, but there's absolutely no question about it. Their work continues to enhance the quality of life in our community, and for that, I thank them. We are also building a more prosperous Macomb. Macomb County's economy is as strong as it's ever been. We continue to experience some of the largest and most technologically advanced investments in the entire state. The most apparent is in our automotive sector. This past year, FCA announced plans to modernize the Warren truck plant to produce the next generation Ram heavy-duty pickup. Together with the completion of the billion-dollar investment at the Sterling Heights Assembly Plant, where they make the Ram 1500, Macomb County will soon be the epicenter of all things Ram. Every one of those trucks are going to be built here in Macomb County, the heavy duty and the 1500. General Motors is also preparing itself for the future. While the most recent announcement to close the Warren Transmission Plant is not welcome news, General Motors continues to make strategic investments in Macomb County. For example, they announced a $28 million investment in a battery lab at their Global Technical Center in Warren, which will create one of the largest battery facilities in the entire world. And because the future of the Cadillac brand is going to be driven by the expertise at the tech center, General Motors announced that they would be moving Cadillac's headquarters from New York back to Macomb County, Michigan. These major automotive investments are creating expansion opportunities for our world-class supplier network of more than 1,600 manufacturing firms. Some of the most recent investments include Schwab Industries in Shelby Township, $5 million. Drake Enterprise in Clinton Township, $18 million. Tooling Technology in Macomb Township, $19 million. And HTI Cybernetics in Sterling Heights, another $20 million. Again, these are just a few of the many manufacturing investments we have seen this past year. The defense sector. Macomb County is the defense capital. We are home to nearly 700 defense contractors. This past year alone, companies were awarded more than $2 billion in Department of Defense contracts, which represents 63% of total defense spending in the state of Michigan. And these contracts are leading to major investments. Lanza, a new $10 million headquarters in Romeo. SAPA Transmission, a Spanish defense contractor, a new $40 million North American headquarters in Shelby Township. And the U.S. Army selected Macomb County as home to their next generation combat vehicle team. And Selfridge secured $90 million to facilitate base improvements. In fact, recently, we strengthened our relationship with Selfridge when General Slocum and I had an opportunity to sign a public-private partnership agreement to better align base priorities with the community and resources so that we can protect our hometown air base. General, thank you for all that you do. On the retail and service side, that industry, C.J. Barrymore's is planning a multi-million dollar expansion. This gets me excited. They're adding new attractions. We just got through getting a roller coaster, which, by the way, one and done. Back when I was a kid, I could do it. one time I was off. But this time, they're bringing a Ferris wheel to Macomb County out at that location. That deserves a round of applause. Are you kidding me? When was the last time we had a Ferris wheel here? Now you better be, I want to say Saunders now, and you guys better be, you know, at least clapping for the bumpy cake or something here, right? Saunders announced the major merger. Hang on, let me finish it. Saunders announced the major merger with Cars in a move that'll combine the two iconic snack brands and expand national distribution. Now you can applaud. I'm going to say it. I was warned not to, but I got to. I wonder if this has anything to do with tomorrow. Those who are laughing, I just identified you. Anybody know what tomorrow is? Oh, there we go. There we go. That guy. So, there's always one in a crowd. So, Blake's continues to grow their farm center and cider operations with an additional $2 million investment. And at Jimmy John's Field, boy, the hits just keep on coming there, man. Pretty much every game was a sellout. Andy, thank you once again for bringing that here to Macomb County. Michigan Lottery Amphitheater at Freedom Hill has a new promoter, 313 Presents, and they're promising some incredible touring acts, if you will, for 2019. And Candace, if you're in the house, I got to thank you because you've been a partner in this one. This is pretty exciting stuff. I see folks pointing her way. She's over here somewhere. There she is. She's hiding in the front row here. The Detroit Zoological Society is planning to build a $15 million Great Lakes Nature Center here in Macomb County, and it'll include aquariums, animal habitats, displays on the science and ecology of our freshwater assets. This is exciting stuff. So, away from the retail side, I got to go back to talking about some of the IT and the cybersecurity stuff that's going on here. It's absolutely amazing. Right now, we have more than 400 companies that make up Macomb County's information technology network. And boy, they employ more than 9,000 highly trained workers. The national average for employment growth in these professions in the past 5 years nationally is 9.5%. The growth has been 132%. The tech trends are helping us develop some innovative programs. We developed cyber testing ranges here in Macomb County, created cyber career pathways, and we're expanding the role of our Michigan Automotive and Defense Cyber Awareness Team, known as MADCAT. But our latest idea is truly something unique. We are launching a first-of-its-kind robotics collaboration and innovation center. The center will offer tools, programs, and expert assistance in an open environment for creative people. The potential benefits of this are endless, and the concept will put Macomb County at the forefront of industry innovation. Clearly, there's an impressive amount of economic activity happening across Macomb County, but we cannot sustain a growing economy unless we offer a workforce that is prepared for the jobs of the future. As we sit here today, there are more than 20,000 unfilled jobs in Macomb County. Many of these remain unfilled because our workforce doesn't have the necessary skills. Folks, this is a national challenge, yet we know it has to be solved through local solutions. Here are some of the ways that we are working to meet those challenges at a pre-baccalaureate level. We have been partnering with the Macomb Intermediate School District on efforts like Manufacturing Day, where we have connected more than 10,000 high school kids to emerging careers. Working with Romeo Community Schools, we officially designated the district as the first Ford Next Generation Learning Community in the state. And you know, I recently saw a video that the kids put together to better explain this. So I'm going to let the kids entertain you for a moment.
As high school students, we crave real-world, authentic experiences because we want to be interested in what we are learning.
In Romeo, our schools partner with Ford Next Generation Learning and the Macomb County Planning and Economic Development Department, bringing together teachers, employers, and community leaders to transform our high school, to make learning more meaningful, and give us the skills we need to be ready for what comes next.
We call this transformation the Academies at Romeo. The Academies at Romeo will allow us to choose a career theme we are interested in, like health, law, manufacturing, information technology, and more.
We'll take math, English, science, and social studies, but they'll be taught through the theme of our academy. Ninth graders will start out in Freshman Academy, where they will learn skills to help them be successful in high school, explore careers, and even visit college campuses.
After this exploration, students choose an academy and pathway for their 10th, 11th, and 12th grade years.
Choosing a pathway, such as health services in the Academy of Health, Human, and Public Services, is like choosing a college major. The academy and pathway we choose becomes a school within a school, where we study with those with similar interests and build strong relationships with our teachers and each other.
No matter what academy or pathway we choose, our courses will relate to real problems being faced by real companies, and we will learn about them both in and out of the classroom. Workplace learning opportunities such as job shadowing and internships will give us hands-on experiences, understanding of career options, and increased technical and soft skills.
And because we learn within a career theme that interests us, school becomes more engaging, relevant, and fun, increasing our academic achievement, attendance, and graduation rates. This will ensure all graduates of Romeo Community Schools have the opportunity to enroll in a college or other post-secondary training option, enlist in military service, or become employed in a sustainable career with opportunities for growth.
Most importantly, it will prepare all of us for college, career, and life. To find out more or to get involved, visit www.romeok12.org.
That was actually created and produced by the kids themselves, which was very interesting because it really sums up and explains exactly what's going on. And that's just Romeo Schools. Here's some of the things that other districts are doing to better connect students' passions with career opportunities. Chippewa Valley Schools has an award-winning medical academy. Centerline Public Schools has an impressive program where graduates are ready to take jobs as EMTs and firefighters. And Utica Community Schools, they continue to expand their manufacturing, automotive design, and engineering program known as MADE. To keep this momentum going, we created the Macomb Talent and Education Consortium, where leaders from the Macomb Intermediate School District, Macomb Community College, and the county, we meet on a regular basis to address the evolving talent needs of tomorrow. And with that being said, tonight I want to announce the next step in preparing Macomb's new-collar workers. This morning, we launched the Fueling the Talent Pipeline initiative. This is a service platform where employers and educators can get connected, share resources, and help students become aware of future career opportunities. So, if you're an employer, an educator, or know of a student who is looking to get connected, please do them a favor. Log on to macombbusiness.com and check out Fueling Talent Pipeline. This is a great opportunity to give kids the moment to see that there might be something they have a passion in. And, you know, I get excited about the future because of what's going on in our schools and those districts. So I want to thank all the school districts and everyone for working with us in the county level to try to help those kids get connected. Now, each year, I tend to end my remarks by talking about the future and then what's on the horizon for Macomb County. And at the top of that list, roads. Did you have a wonderful drive here today? We are entering that season once again where the condition of the roads will again be a major public concern. And you know, the good news is that there has been some improvement in state funding, yet it is still woefully inadequate. For example, when you hear that there's a $1 billion increase at the state level, that sounds like a big number. But you know what that translates to? About $5 million for Macomb County Department of Roads. Now, there's reasons why. And whatever they're going to do in Lansing, I don't want to be prescriptive. But whatever that solution is that is proposed, I want to make sure that it amounts to real money. You see, it's not about fixing the roads. We can do that. It's about fixing the funding for roads that's necessary. And here's an example of what can be done with adequate funding. One of our greatest success stories this past year was a major federal grant award that we received. to innovate Mound Road. This dynamic partnership we created with industry leaders in the cities of Warren and Sterling Heights, as well as the county, we were able to create and rethink and rebuild one of the most important roadways in Southeast Michigan. This $97.8 million grant was the largest Department of Transportation grant ever awarded to a local unit of government. And you see, it's not about rebuilding the entire roadway, which is what most people just want to see. And we're going to do that from 696 to Hall Road. But we're also going to include an intelligent transportation system designed to integrate future mobility technologies. The construction on that road will begin in about 18 months. And when it is completed, it will have transformed one of the worst roads to one of the most advanced in the entire nation. Another item on the horizon is making a decision on what to do about the county jail. Simply put, our current jail is too old, too small, and too expensive to operate. More importantly, our outdated facility doesn't allow us to utilize proven best practices in the criminal justice system. As I mentioned last year, we brought in consultants to study the situation, and they have provided us with alternatives. And as you might imagine, each of those carries a significant price tag. These alternatives will be carefully evaluated over the next 6 months, and a more detailed cost will be determined for each. The goal will be to identify a specific plan before the end of the year. I also, on the horizon, look at planned improvements that we have here in Macomb County with the areas of parks, trails, and natural resources. The Department of Public Works, incredible job she's doing over there. I can't say enough about her. I mean, I'm so glad she's our Public Works Commissioner. Candace, thank you. So, it's a night and day difference, folks. I can only say that since I got the microphones, I'm going to say it. I mean, it's like, we're working, our planning departments are working with Public Works now. Road department is working with Public Works now. I mean, and those things are so, they're so intimately needed to be involved, and it's happening. So the exciting things that are happening across this county is a direct reflection of the leadership in that office. And most recently, she just announced that they're going to be leveraging $2 million in federal funds. Your tax dollars coming back home because she knows how to do that, to revitalize the Sterling Relief Drain. Candace, thank you. Huron Clinton Metropolitan Authority is planning a $500,000 beach enhancement at Lake St. Clair Metro Park. My father is sitting over here saying, it's Metro Beach. Quit calling it that. So, I know, Pine Knob, DTE, whatever. So, and the county will also, we're going to be completing our new master plan for parks, trails, and natural resources. You know, and just looking at the future and trying to figure out, you know, where we're headed here, whatever. Thinking of the future, and I think many of you do. I do more so now because I'm connected with my nephew and my nieces, and just having them as part of my life, I worry about them and I wonder about them. And you know, it's impossible to think about the future without thinking about our children. And we do have, and I mentioned it earlier, a great educational system here. A proud graduate of public schools, this community college, and I can't imagine having a better place for educational opportunities than here in Macomb County. And with that being said, I do want to close this evening by at least highlighting just one of them, specifically for a reason. And as part of its mission, the Macomb Intermediate School District works with students who need special education services. Every fall, I have an opportunity to attend the opening day ceremonies at the ISD, where I have a chance to meet with their staff and dozens of their students. During this year's program, a ninth grade student from Glen Peters School, who was visually impaired, sang a song that I'd heard before. But I'm gonna tell you, I never really listened to the words until I heard her perform that song. It taught me two lessons as I listened to the words for the first time. First, it reminded me that there are many people in our community who are facing challenges, and yet they find the strength to overcome them. Secondly, it taught me to see people as having disabilities merely not to notice their disabilities, but to recognize them as having different abilities. Because I was so moved by this, I decided at that moment that I was going to invite her here to hopefully inspire you as well. She took me up on that offer. Ladies and gentlemen, Nevaeh McIntosh.
Yeah. I can almost see it, that dream I'm dreaming, but there's a voice inside my head saying, you'll never reach it. Every step I'm taking, every move I make feels lost with no direction. My faith is shaking, but I gotta keep trying. Gotta keep my head held high. There's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes we're gonna have to lose. In about how fast I get there. In about what's waiting on the other side. Climb. The struggles I'm facing, the chances I'm taking, sometimes might knock me down, but no, I'm not breaking. I may not know it, but these are the moments that I'm gonna remember most of. Just gotta keep going, and I gotta be strong. Just keep pushing on, 'cause there's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes we're gonna have to lose. In about how fast I get there. In about what's waiting on the other side. It's a climb. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes I'm gonna have to lose. In about how fast I get there. In about what's waiting on the other side. It's a climb. Yeah. Keep on moving, keep on it,
Maybe I want to thank you for being a special part of this evening. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you're as proud as I am of this place we call home. And as you look around, it's the people of this county who make us what we are. I want to thank all of you for being a part of this evening's celebration. And I want to wish all of you a happy and safe holiday season. Thank you for attending.
Hello, I'm Bob Cannon, your Township Supervisor, and I'm here with Ken Pearl. Ken and I love to come to Mark Hackel's State of the County address, and I want to invite all the people in Clinton Township to, in a couple months, watch the State of Clinton Township address also. We'll be doing it on the last Friday in January, and that evening it'll be on the air and probably for several weeks after, so you can see what's happening not only in Macomb County tonight, but also in Clinton Township in late January. Ken, what are your initial impressions of Mark's?
You know, another fabulous presentation, really hallmarking what's important in Macomb County and why people make Macomb County their home.
One of the things he talked about, which is very dear to you, is education and the ISD.
Yeah, you know, the ISD represents education for the whole community, for the whole county. All the school districts are involved in a cooperative effort, and they do a lot of education for the kids that needed extra special help. And some of the things that he's working with is things that Chippewa's been doing for years with their nursing group, their medical group, and with the CTE group building homes with Habitat for Humanity.
It's been a fabulous program.
You know, so these are important things, and he's really working together to make things even better so kids have a pathway
there
to
were
a job.
Many things he said tonight that were nice and astonishing, but one of those is how many jobs are available that we can't fill today because the people who live in Macomb County and elsewhere don't have the necessary skills.
Well, that's why he's working on that, and I'm really glad that we have a chief executive of the county that's working together with the whole county, with employers, with schools, and colleges.
Well, we're lucky, Ken, that we have a guy who's apolitical for the most part, who goes out and does what's right for the entire county, regardless of party affiliation.
That's absolutely true. You know, he does a fabulous job.
Jeff Bohm, you are the head commissioner in St. Clair County. You basically are the Mark Hackel of St. Clair. And I know that you guys get along very well. Give us your impressions of what happened tonight with Mark's presentation.
Well, it's always just so refreshing to come down here and see everything that's positive that's happening in Macomb County, because so often I talk about it, 35% of our residents in St. Clair County actually seek employment in Macomb County. So I can't even underestimate how important it is for Macomb County to do well, to have St. Clair County to do well, and vice versa. I know a lot of times, you know, when Mark's bringing in, you heard today that they bring in a lot of people, a lot of growth. Sometimes St. Clair County becomes an alternative for those individuals seeking employment for another opportunity to live. As you well know, we have a lot of the waterfront assets. I can just tell you the relationships are fantastic. Mark's a tremendous leader. We do a lot of regional planning, and the relationships are excellent with him.
And you take all of us joking at your expense in good heart.
Well, I can assure you when he comes to St. Clair County, I throw it back.
I'm sure you do it twice.
You gotta know when you come down here, and it's joking, and really it's all in great fun. And those are the kinds of relationships that you have to have, and you really respect one another, and you understand it's a regional issue. You know, so when we talk, it's not about St. Clair County. It's not even about Macomb. It's the whole region in general. So we really, I know it gets used a lot. You know, you talk about the region, but we preach it, and we really reinforce it, and we totally believe in it, and that's why we're here to support these guys and all their efforts today.
You are so important to us. You have the crossing up there, the bridge. We have 94, which is a constant corridor between our counties, really.
Yeah, you think about the flow of traffic and everything. I was just down at SEMCOG today, as you're obviously a part of that, the Southeastern Michigan Council of Governance, and you know, just so often talk about being the transportation hub and you know where we fit into it, and just great conversations with everybody and you know, in the entire region. And I know you're a big proponent of all the regionalism efforts and everything too. So
well, I'm proud to have you as a friend, and I'm proud that you're a friend of Mark Hackel's, because it's such a great relationship, and you've done a lot to help us here too. So keep doing what you're doing. We appreciate it.
Well, you guys keep doing all the great things. Great to see the growth here, and just literally, I can't tell you how excited I get to see how well Macomb County's doing, and I mean that from the bottom of my heart.
Jim Sawyer, president of Macomb Community College.
Hi, Bob. How are you? Good to see you.
Fantastic place. Every time I come here, it's a different experience. A show, an exhibit, see kids, classes, bees out back, out there, food service. But tonight was something special, and I know you enjoy hosting this.
Oh, we always really, we appreciate the opportunity Mark affords us to really highlight the college, to host this real important event. It's a great event for the community. Everyone, you know, gets to hear how the county's been the past year, and what's lies ahead for us in the future. And to have them come to the college and be able to experience that and have this taste festival afterwards is really nice.
Well, it certainly highlights a lot of the great places we have in Macomb County. Now, he talked a lot about education. He emphasized some things that you're doing here at the college in partnerships.
Well, partnerships are key to education. We work very closely with the ISD as well as the 21 districts in the county. And really, we work closely with Oakland University and Wayne State University, who have presence here in the county as well. So we're really about working together to try to create educational pathway for students all the way from K-12 right through baccalaureate and master's degrees.
Well, he talked about the lack of people available for jobs that we have here in Macomb County, and that was a staggering number.
Well, that's a challenge for us, and we work closely with the county too, trying to retrain people. But that's one of the areas where funding's actually been cut over the years. So it's a challenge to find funding to do those training programs for displaced workers and incumbent workers. We do work with Michigan Works, trying to identify opportunities when we can. But you know, the big thing is trying to get people interested in those careers. That's a big challenge as well.
Well, the going into the schools has been big for you, and I know that it's been big for Mark. And I saw what Romeo is doing. That's fantastic.
Yeah, the Romeo program is very interesting, and they've been good about pulling in a variety of partners to work with them. And we're real anxious to see how the whole Ford Next Generation Learning gets operationalized and how successful it is.
Perfect, and I'm sure you'll incorporate that right into your curriculum.
Oh, absolutely.
Thank you, Bob. General Slocum, you are in charge out of Selfridge, one of the big economic boosters of our area and also the big protector of our area and also a source of great pride for all of Macomb County and Southeast Michigan.
Well, there's a lot of great men and women that work out there, and they're doing a lot of great work, and we are very proud of them. I'll tell you what, and that this last year, just like Mark was just highlighting in his speech, there's a lot of great things happening.
And you've got some new things that have come to your base.
Yeah, very recently, we just did the ribbon cutting on a veterans traumatic brain injury transition center. They're going to be a new tenant, so the Eisenhower Center is going to be coming out there and refurbishing some facilities and some of the old housing. What a win-win for the county and for our veterans.
It certainly is. And speaking of veterans, you had some very special veterans out there the other day, and I was at the luncheon that you were at with them and some of the others from Macomb County.
Are we talking the Tuskegee Airmen luncheon?
We are.
Okay, you bet. The Detroit chapter of the Tuskegee Airmen have been great wingmen with us through a number of years, but what a rich history they have. And we had a couple of what they call DOTAs, Detroit, or Documented Original Tuskegee Airmen. These are the guys from World War II that had served all the way through in Tuskegee, came through Selfridge and overseas, and what a great story it was. But to have the entire chapter, or most of the chapter there with us, was just fantastic.
Oh, I felt honored to be in the same room with those men.
Yes, I mean, they have stories to tell, and I tell you, you get them alone talking, and boy, the stories fly. But it includes Selfridge. I mean, it's part of our heritage. It's part of our history here in this county.
And you named a road after them recently.
We did, right by our dining facility, the Tuskegee Airmen Way. We did that last year. I mean, great pride that we get to, you know, label that road in the name of some of the great airmen that have served out at our base.
You bet. And I'm certainly appreciative of the fact that you work very closely with Mark and really everybody in this area whenever they need something from you.
Well, we are all about community partnerships. I mean, we are the National Guard. So it's great. Mark has been a wonderful wingman for us. We've had so many success stories from the traffic circle out front to a lot of the partnerships. And I tell you what, there's a lot of exciting things on the horizon also. When he talked about the partnerships agreement, when he showed that picture, there's a lot of stuff in work, so I think we're only scratching the surface of what is going to continue to be just a great partnership between the base and the community.
That's music to my ears and music to the ears of everyone in Macomb County.
Outstanding. We look forward to it. The next 100 years of suffrage are going to be amazing.
That'll be great, General. Thank you.
Thanks.
The Clinton Township Kiwanis do a lot for our community. Phil, you're the current president.
Correct.
And they tease you all the time. They tease you because you have a habit of being late, but now that you're president, you've been on time.
Well, five times now, so, you know, it's like a world record. And after 30 years, you know, five times on time, it's like they're waiting for me to miss a meeting, so.
Okay, well, I'm going to go away from there because I want to talk about what you guys are doing coming up. I know it's too late to talk about the chili cook-off, which is going to be actually tomorrow night,
right.
But you have a big, big deal coming up in January.
Our biggest fundraiser of the year is the Wild Game Dinner at Fernhill, which is Friday, January 25th. We have between 550 and 600 people that come out, and it's wild dinner or wild game prepared by Fernhill. Open bar. We have a great time.
They do a fabulous job at Fernhill with all this wild game dinner.
So the big thing is it's our 27th year. We're one of the first wild games in the area, and we have plenty of tables available. Anybody wants to come out, just contact Clinton Township Kiwanis, go on our website or our Facebook page.
That'll be perfect. And you've got another member here who just recently had a big election. Mike McDonald, you now represent us up in Lansing, and you are our state senator.
Yes, I am. You know, I'm just proud to be a part of a great organization like the Clinton Township Kiwanis, big supporter. And I hope to be a great emissary for Clinton Township.
Well, I'm going to have your phone number on my speed dial because if we need anything in Lansing, I'm going to have to call you, all right?
Hey, call me anytime, Bob.
That's good. And I know that you've been to Mark's speech before. What were some of the highlights that you thought about tonight? I know you're going up to Lansing. You're fresh in this kind of a job, obviously. What did you come away with?
Well, the big one is the focus on defense. I think there's a great opportunity for Macomb County in defense, and I think it's going to lead to economic prosperity for Macomb.
Very good. And I tell you what, thank you so much for what you do. Anyone who volunteers in the community is fabulous. We are having fewer and fewer people join our service clubs. So if you have a service club in mind, this would be a wonderful one to join. It's not just men, it's men and women. They meet in Clinton Township. What days do you meet?
Wednesday morning, 7:30 a.m. at Ken's Country Kitchen. And we do also have a satellite club that meets once a month.
Very good. So anybody can stop by anytime. I was there once when people who looked on the webpage stopped in and they were welcomed like they were long lost friends. So thanks for what you guys are doing and good luck up in Lansing.
Thank you, Bob.
Thank you, Bob.
Yeah.
RJ Koss, you are a member of the Clinton Township Kiwanis Club.
Yes.
You own a business in Clinton Township.
Yes.
Your dad was a member of the Kiwanis Club in Clinton Township. And you recently just dropped off a lot of gifts to the good fellows in Clinton Township as a result of a party that you gave. Tell me a little bit about that, then we'll talk about Mark's speech.
Yeah, so every year we have an annual client appreciation party to give thanks to our great clients that we help out throughout the year and throughout their life. So as them coming to dinner, we ask them to bring a gift, or a lot of them bring a few gifts to help out the Clinton Township Goodfellas, because it's near and dear to my heart to help out the kids of Clinton Township. So
you've got a big heart, I do know that. Now, back to Mark's speech. You're here, you're a businessman,
mm-hmm.
Things do look good for you right now. What did you come away with Mark's speech tonight?
What I came away with is a great feeling of why I'm so happy to not only to be a business owner in Clinton or Macomb County, but also a resident of Macomb County. And just the initiatives that are being put forth and what they're doing, you know, to help this county grow and become a place that people want to live and have their businesses, I think, you know, we're in no better place in Michigan or in the United States right now that we could be as a family. So
now, I know you went to De La Salle, so yes. You probably were happy with that football program.
Yes, I had a son on the team, so it was awesome. Yeah,
Very good.
Yes.
Very good.
It was
good. Thanks for what you do for the community. Thanks for having a business, a vibrant business here in Clinton Township.
Right, thank you. Appreciate everything you do. All right, thank you.
Kim, it's always fun to see Mark Hackel,
oh,
especially
yeah.
when he's at his prime like this. He's a great cheerleader for Macomb County.
What a great report. Oh, my goodness. It was really a great event tonight. I'm really excited about these smart roads. I don't know what that's all about. It was kind of mysterious, but I like what's coming. Anything to develop our roads, make them better, make them safer, make them smoother, I am all for.
Well, I think the technology they're talking about is when we don't have to have a driver for cars. Mm-hmm. And they're putting this right into the roads. And I'm afraid that it's a great concept. I'm afraid by the time they get it put in, the technology will be obsolete.
Well, we'll see. Artificial intelligence, though, they say that that's a, you know, it's a balancing act because we don't want to put people out of work. You know, artificial intelligence is great. It'll help us be safer and so on. But we still want to employ people, so we got to be careful. There's it's a balancing act.
No question about that.
Yeah.
Also, the number of jobs. You have worked with Clintondale in their robotics program to keep that program alive when it was ready to fail. Why did you do that? And did it kind of play into what Mark was saying tonight, that we have a lot of people that don't have jobs, but we have a lot of jobs that can't be filled because they don't have the skills?
That's one of the biggest difficulties with manufacturing right now. We are the hub for manufacturing, but we need students that want to work in the area of manufacturing. And in some cases, you do not have to go to college for that. So we want to capture those students that may not want to go to college, but want to start working. And these jobs pay very well. And maybe further down the road, with the money that they've made, then they can go to college if they want to at that time. But they don't have to go to college right out of high school. They can get a great manufacturing job right here, and there's the work with not only the automotive, but then we have Selfridge, we have the defense industry, so there's a lot of opportunity for students in that regard.
That is good. I started as a teacher in Utica schools in 1975, and I was in the business distributive ed department, where CTE was extremely important. We were the largest department in the school. By the time I retired from teaching to come to this job, that was one of the smaller departments in the school because they had de-emphasized the fact that kids can get good jobs, good paying jobs, right out of high school or maybe after a year or two of some training.
Training is very important. There are opportunities out there, so I'm really hoping and hopeful that students will be directed. They'll see the value of it and, you know, make that money. It's a great opportunity to make money first as opposed to having to pay any college debt. And I'm not saying not to go to college if you want to,
right.
But if you can have that opportunity to get a good job, work a really good skill, and then maybe pay for your college without having to pay, go into debt for it would be, I think, a good option as well.
Good. Well, Kim, you made a lot of young men and women very happy at Clintondale by saving the robotics program, and I thank you on behalf of those children, their families, and those employers who are looking to hire them.
You know what? The Clintondale students, they're an amazing group of kids. They're fighting to get into this robotics team because it's been so developed so well by one of the teachers that is there, Steve Moskow.
Yeah.
So he's done a great job. He's developed it. We're working in collaboration. We're trying to develop and get more sponsors. And anybody that I've asked that wants to sponsor the Clintondale robotics team has said yes. So we're looking for more sponsors. So if anybody out there is listening and you want to sponsor the Clintondale robotics team, we would love to have you help us out.
Thank you, Kim.
Thank you.
Candace Miller, you have become a close ally of Mark Hackel over the last, not just 2 years, but even before that. And you saw him at his prime tonight.
You know, he did such a great job, and I'm not just saying that because he is my friend, but I think the voters of Macomb County did the right thing when they voted for the county charter.
I do too.
Because we really, you know, we were sort of a county of a lot of wonderful parts, but then they did the right thing by voting for Mark Hackel for county executive because he has been able to bring all the pieces together and sort of put the puzzle together, if you will, and really make us strong, I think.
Well, I've said this many times before. Mark has supported me as a Republican, and he's a Democrat, and he came out and supported you over a very strong Democrat in Macomb County, not taking a chance and not even caring. He did what was right for Macomb County.
Well, and you and I support Democrats, right? And you know what we are? We're really typical Macomb County voters.
Exactly.
Because we support the person. And the person that's getting the job done and the person that has the vision. And but anyway, tonight was a great, great night. And I don't know if your viewers are going to be able to see the final part of that when that little girl got up and sang.
They're going to get it.
This little girl that was special needs and sang this I'm telling you what, there was not a dry eye in the place. And it does put everything into perspective.
It does.
And really, how many people have challenges and overcome those challenges and face them? And that's sort of Macomb County, right? I mean, we might not be the glitziest place in the world, but one thing we do, we get up every single day and work hard all day, right?
We do.
Build things and make things. And this is a county, a community of faith, of family, our community. And I think Mark's slogan about make Macomb your home sort of brings all that together as well.
At first it sounded a little corny when he started it a few years back, but it certainly is us now.
Yeah, well you sort of have to have a brand, you have to have a slogan.
Yeah.
You got to get people's attention. And I do think the way that he's been messaging on all these things has been very helpful for the county. And it is good for us to have a voice at the table now with all these other counties, Oakland and Wayne and the big counties. We have, you know, Macomb has always been sort of the forgotten child over here in the corner.
Yeah.
Now we're right there.
Well, and that's a lot of what you just said. It's nice that Mark has such a nice rapport with the other county executives that he can poke fun of them.
Yes.
In front of them, in front of a crowd here in Macomb County.
Yeah. So he had Warren Evans from Wayne, Brooks Patterson from Oakland, and Jeff Bohm from St. Clair County. I think that really speaks well to Mark that you have these other media in our region, the leaders, that came to hear him tonight.
And the last thing I would like to say to you, thank you for offering us the opportunity to partner on the park behind your building. It seems to me that you're pretty proud of that little sign out there that says Clinton Township and Macomb County are partners again.
You know, we've partnered on a lot of different things, but we don't always put a sign in front of them.
I know.
But yes, that was a park that was very underutilized. And I called you and said, you know, Bob, we really need to do something here and open it up to the public, let people know, but I need a little help. Man, you were right there.
It didn't take long.
It did not take long, and your Parks and Recreation Department is there all the time.
That's good.
And you know what? People are going. I see people going in there all the time.
I hear about it. They're very happy. Thank you.
Yeah, so it's good. Thanks.
It was fun tonight.
Thank you.
It's been a great evening here at Macomb Community College. Thanks for watching CTTV. Same time, same place next year. Mark Hackel will do another fantastic job. And again, remember, the State of the Township address is the last Friday in January. It will be on the air that evening, and probably for 2 or 3 weeks after that, you'll have an opportunity to see it. It will then be on YouTube for your viewing pleasure. Thank you. See you soon.